Hello, my name is Gustavo Gallas from copahost.com web hosting. In this video, we will talk about HTML font colors, font families, paragraph tags, and line breaks. The HTML protocol allows you to customize font colors, font families, or anything you can imagine. First of all, we're going to make a paragraph tag with some text. So I'm going to save the page and see how a standard paragraph tag looks like. So a clean paragraph tag will look like black, the black text. First, to customize the color, we have to use the style attribute. You can go here inside the P tag, the paragraph tag, and do like this, style. Inside the style attribute, we can make many customizations to any HTML tag. To customize the color of the tags, we are going to use the color attribute. We're simply needing to use the color blue, just like this. Now the text is blue. I'm going to duplicate the paragraph tag. And now to this other paragraph tag, I'm going to use the same style attribute, now with the red color. This is how it looks. To organize things, I'm going to edit the text, setting here, for instance, blue text, now red text. So this is how you can customize the color using the style and the color attribute inside it. You can set the color using the name of the color, just like blue, red, or green, or else you can set the HTML value of the color. At the Copahost blog, there is an article with all the color codes you can use. You can see here the color names and the HTML codes. So for instance, I'm going to copy the green code. This is the code reference I'm going to copy and place inside the style attribute. I'm going to save the file. And then it's how it looks like. So here I use the color code of it. Now we're going to see how to change the font size and font family. So we have used the attribute font size, just like this. You can use font size and the size in pixels. As you can see here, the text is bigger. I'm going to duplicate the paragraphs tag. And now using an even bigger text. Now with 40 pixels. So it looks even bigger. Now we can customize the font face, the font family. I'm going to make another paragraph tag. And use the font family attribute. I'm going to use the Arial family. So this is our text with the Arial font. Let me try another different font here. Let's try Times New Roman here. So now in this other paragraph, we have set the font as Times New Roman. And we have a slightly difference here in the font family, in the font face. Let's try a different font, the Impact, which is a bolder font. So we have the different font face here. It's very easy to set. You have only to use the font family attribute inside the style attribute of the P tag. Now I'm going to talk about the BR, the line break tag. I'm going to create a new paragraph with more text. So we have now a paragraph with several texts inside it. Let's see how it looks like by default. So by default, we have these texts here. So how can we insert a line break between them? We can simply use the BR tag, like this. Let's reload the page. Now we can see that after the second sentence, we have the line break here. Let me add one more line break for you to see easily how it looks like. So we have given two line breaks here. The more BR tags you insert, the more line breaks you will have. The BR tag is a tag that you don't need to close. You can only use one BR and you are good to go. For example, I'm going to use more BR inside the sentence here. Now, as we place two BRs after the word sum, we have here the sum and two line breaks with more space here. For instance, if we place several BRs in the end, we will give four line breaks, just like this example. We have the sentence some text, four line breaks, and here the last word. So we have here some text, several empty lines here, one line for each BR tag we used, and then here the last word of it. The BR tag is a very simple tag to use. So thanks for watching. We're going to show more HTML customizations in the next videos.